Hi, welcome back. I'm sure now you are ready for the next lesson and you already watched my previous lesson. If you have not watched it, go back to it and where I talked about myths about hypnosis, what hypnosis is. Now, if you have not subscribed yet, subscribe to the channel, click on the button on the notification button so that you get the messages next time and remember to like the video if you really like it. And now in this video, we'll talk about how our mind works. Now, we have a conscious mind, we have a subconscious mind. So, I have a few questions for you. What is the time you wake up in the morning? Usual time. When I ask this question, people say between 5 to 9. Then I select a time, average time, say 7 o'clock. Then I ask them a question. If it is one of the days, if you have to wake up in the morning earlier than your normal time, what do you do? Say 5 o'clock, what do you do? You set an alarm. Now, my friend, I have a question for you. With how many times this happened to you? You went up to sleep, set an alarm for 5 o'clock, went up to sleep, and a few seconds before the alarm rings, your eyes open, you are wide awake. It happened to you? I'm sure it happened to you, it happened with everybody. Now my question is, you were sleeping, dreaming, unconscious, who wakes you up? Now, somebody say there's a clock inside, there's no clock inside, you wake you up. Because you have programmed your mind, your subconscious mind wakes you up. Now my friend, if your subconscious mind can wake you up, it can do a lot of things for you. Alright? Whatever position you are now in your business, your profession, your studies, if you think that you have not achieved something, that means there is a wrong programming in your subconscious mind. For example, let me ask you another question, an interesting question. Again, one night before you went up to sleep, set an alarm for 5 o'clock and then you woke up at 1. Then 2, then 3, then 4, then 4:30, 4:45, and you woke up for a few seconds at 5 o'clock and then finally you woke up, it was 7:30. Happened with you? Happened with me? Sure, happened with you. So, if you're sleeping, see, the subconscious awake you at 5 o'clock, then who keeps you awake whole night this time? Again, your subconscious mind only, it's a wrong programming. Out of fear, tension, anxiety that you may not able to wake up in time, if before you went out to sleep, you keep on to say, you said 5 o'clock, but you said early in the morning, number of time, and subconscious mind doesn't know what you meant in the morning. And it wakes, keeps you awake whole night. So my friend, subconscious mind take things literally, doesn't reason. All the reason in your conscious mind. Clear? Now, if you wake up at 7 o'clock in the morning, we say 9 o'clock is the time to go to your workplace. And with how many of this happen? You started your vehicle at 9 o'clock, came out of your house, started moving towards your workplace, and then suddenly you find that your mind is somewhere else, you started thinking what things to be done today, what phone calls to be done today, and only when you reach your parking lot of your workplace, you realize that you reached. You don't even remember what happened on the way. There was a traffic signal, you stopped, somebody came in front of you, you applied your brakes and you came correctly to your workplace. With how many of these happen? With everybody. So tell me, if your mind was somewhere else, who was driving your vehicle? Your subconscious mind. How it knows? Same thing every day, same time, going to that place. Now my friend, when something is programmed, your subconscious mind becomes automatic and effortless. Subconscious mind works like an automatic pilot. Yes. Now, remember a time when you were learning to drive a four-wheeler, you're looking down and applying your brakes. But after 15 days, what happens? There's a need to apply brake. Do you think about it? Your leg is already there. And the funny thing is, when you're not driving or somebody else is driving or sitting on the front seat, there's a need to apply brakes before your friend or whatever the driver driving the car, he applies brake. You have applied a brake on your side, though there is no brakes. Because it's a programming in your subconscious mind. The subconscious mind, automatic pilot, when something is programmed, it becomes automatic and effortless. Now, I have another question for you. You met a very interesting person very first time in a party or meeting, a long time back, 15 days back, you exchanged your card. Today, after 15 days, suddenly you started thinking about that person. You know how does it look like? You know how does it look like? What he was wearing? What kind of discussion you had, but something is missing. What is that missing? The name. The harder you try, the more difficult it becomes. You keep on saying, jawan pe nahi aa raha hai, you know, it's not coming, it is on my tongue, it is in my hands, head somewhere, not coming out. And then when you stop thinking about that person, After 15 or 20 minutes, you stop thinking about the person, boom, the name comes in. With how many of this happened? With everybody that happened. So where was the name stored? In your subconscious mind. Why you're not able to recall it? You're trying hard to recall it. And you're trying hard, you become tense. When you become tense, what happens? You create a block between your conscious mind and subconscious mind. And after 15 minutes, you stop thinking about it. You were relaxed. The block was removed. Subconscious mind find out the name and give it to you. Happen? It happened with everybody. Remember, subconscious mind has a permanent memories. Conscious mind has temporary memories. Other important thing about subconscious mind is all our emotions are stored in our subconscious mind. When we are emotional, our conscious mind doesn't work properly. Conscious mind works, but the critical factory doesn't work. You are already in a kind of hypnosis. Many times it happened to you that you have done something wrong when you are emotional, later on you felt bad about it. Most of the problem of illness we suffer because of the time when we were emotional, we take a wrong suggestion or negative suggestion that goes into subconscious mind and we don't remember it. And then we suffer. All automatic function in your body like our breathing, you know, all other things are being controlled by your subconscious mind. Subconscious mind is 95% of the total mind power, and sometimes people say it is 99.99% and conscious mind it will. So now my friend, through hypnosis, self-hypnosis, you can reprogram your subconscious mind consciously. So my friend, this is about conscious mind, subconscious mind. The next lesson we talk about rules of the mind to let you know how the mind works and what happens. So keep watching the video. If you have not yet subscribed, subscribe to the channel. Like it, click on the like button and click onto the bell button so that you will be notified whenever a new video comes. And we are coming back a lot of videos to teach you how to do hypnosis. This is a channel for Learn Hypnosis Now, and you can do it by watching me doing it. So thank you very much and see you in the next video. Thank you.